arms at the ready, these men defend against the threats in northern Mali. They're on the front line of what some call the world's deadliest peacekeeping mission.
We're joining a team of peacekeepers from Bangladesh. They've invited us on a patrol with them, so we'll head a little out of the town to see how they go about their operations.
We set off and slowly edge into the unknown. But the task at hand is enormous.
The trade, we don't know basically what is the trade over here, but trade is all over there. There is no conventional trade. There is a trade of IDF, ID, and other types of thing, harassing fire, ambush, all those things. So once the trade is not known to us, that is the asymmetric trade, and we are looking for that.
This is the gateway to the Sahara. From here on, it's vast expanses of land. The harsh terrain is hell for vehicles. The heat, of course, is unforgiving. And that makes it challenging, if not impossible, to police. And so groups like people smugglers, drug traffickers, and militants can thrive here.
Minutes later, an armed convoy. Out here in Africa's Wild West, that could be anybody. But these appear to be aligned to the government and not a threat to us. These groups operate despite the presence of the UN's troops. The international community has poured close to $1 billion into this mission in the past year alone. Still, the state has little control here in the north. The area is a haven for jihadist movements, and a peace deal between the government and various armed groups has fallen apart. After a period of relative calm, violence has flared up again. Many of the war wounded are brought here to the region's only hospital. Some of the men in this ward were wounded in the fighting. They belong to one of the armed groups. Civilians, too, are not spared. This man was in a fuel tanker which drove over an explosive device. Two of his colleagues were killed.
I was conscious when they brought me here. But to be honest, I can't tell you what happened at the time of the explosion.
Back in the Sahel, the troops keep watch. The countless groups and interests spread across the region mean this military solution can only go so far. Tomi Oladipo, BBC News, Northern Mali.